Hello, folks, it's the Grub back again with some more Empyrion Galactic Survival. And, just kinda walking through, went and did a little touch-ups here and there, was checking some doors. I was having a case for some of my doors. It wouldn't show on these here, because these, I think I got some food in me. There we go. But, some of these doors were, like, I fixed this one, but what was happening was when this was opening, the door was showing up on the outer face. It was doing it out here and that one over there, so I had to fix the doors a little bit. I've added an ATM machine. I've already got 550 credits from completing that green eating Akua quest. Gotta get to Omicron to get the next set of those. But I've also, I'm gonna say finished, though. I mean, I can push it back further if need be. But I have my little hangar, my small ship's hangar bay. I even tried doing a little bit of decorating here, which, you know, yeah. I got some lights in here, some work lights here along the back. Two of these doors, as you saw. And I decided to change up. Instead of having the green strip down there, I decided we'll do it green on the right. I'm sorry, green on the left. So that it's always on the left when you're landing, and it'll always be on the left when you go to take off. And I should have done that. Oof. One of the bad things is jetpack turns off automatically whenever you restart a game, and yeah, I just restarted this thing. But yeah, got a little antenna up there. This actually looks kind of cool from a distance at night. With the lights. Maybe when it gets back to it, we'll come back and check it up in the evening hours. But that was what I wanted to show off there, that we got in the air, the small craft bay fixed. And looks like we're just about done getting our large fuel cells. I wanted to make sure I had a lot of those in reserve. Also crafted up some ammo for my sniper rifle. So I had that on hand. I still have my explosives. But I think it's time to start getting ready for the small ship. And hardened steel plate. What does a hardened steel plate take? Okay, yeah, I just don't have enough Sathium yet. I've only got 4 ingots of Sathium, so our first small ship is just gonna have to be regular steel blocks. Make about 200 of those. Get the small vessel starter. I should have an extra core over here. Yes. All right. And then the ghost door. So yeah, we will get that. I will let that start up, and then we will get ready to design our well, I won't say it's my first small spacecraft. I have made little spacecraft before, but first one for this series, the first one that's going to be set to try design specifically to fit inside. Yeah, I could have gone in and used the elevator, but fuck it. Fit inside our hangar bay here. In fact, I'm going to try and design it in here. Right over here, I'll try to design it. It almost would be worth it to bring it up here, but nah, not gonna make things easy for me. I'm gonna run up and down all day, every day. Let's see, I'm gonna need, let me go ahead and just pre-make some of the stuff I am gonna need here. Gonna take a mobile constructing kit with me as well. Going to need a generator. Do I have a? Oops. Okay, yeah, just make sure it was small craft. Let's see here. Definitely gonna need some O2 tanks and an O2 station. Take a fridge with me just in case. Have any other generators? Okay, I take that. Two fuel tanks. Definitely need some RCS. And I know I'm gonna need some engines, but I gotta figure out what I'll need. I think these are best going on the outside wings and that, so. I may not be able to do it. Alright, anyway, I'll be back once I have the majority of this stuff all made up, and then we will start laying down the ship, and once we really get into the building of it, we'll probably move into speed up. While I'm waiting for this to craft up, though, I do want to give another little shout out to Button Pusher, once again, coming up with some answers to questions I had previously. When I was destroying my base, it was giving me components back, even though I had it set for disassemble. Oops, don't want to do that. Apparently, don't know if it's a bug or it's just something that's changed, because it used to be I didn't have to do that when I was doing it on a single-player game. You didn't have to change your base around, but apparently, I had to make sure my base was set on private. Otherwise, it was set as public, and it would have just given me back the components instead of the actual part itself, which was kind of becoming annoying when I'd make a mistake, and I'd have to run all the way back down when I only made one of some, because I expected I only needed the one of something. So I want to thank you again there, Button Pusher. For helping me out figure that little issue out. So yeah, like I said, I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to wait for enough of this stuff to craft up so that we can get started. And I will be back once we are ready to go. Alright folks, well, I have just about everything I think I may need. I may have to run down once or twice to get a few other little things here, but I think I got just about everything I need to get a small ship up and running here. Just go place this here. Of course, this is not going to be the actual ship. This is just the starter block so that we can build off of. Boop. And while I'm on it, just in case. Okay, see now, it did it automatically. It made it private. It should have, but every now and then you get it where it doesn't do that. Let me, So yeah, I'm gonna try and just kind of design something here. I have no real plans. I don't think I'll even want it that wide. Yeah, so anyway, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to start working on this. We'll see how things go. Got those before the gravity got them. But yeah, so we'll get to work on this, and I will be back once we have completed. Like I said, it'll be a probably a time-lapse video again. I've been hearing any complaints about them. That was weird. Okay, anyway. let me put this back here just for stability reasons. Like I said, anyway, gonna be start a time lapse, and we'll get to building. So here we go. Well, it's done. It's not the prettiest thing in the world, and you may notice I had a little bit of an impromptu flight, which directed me to go ahead and make a few changes. I need to add a few a bit more powerful forward front-facing thrusters there, but here it is. 3 Gatling guns, 2 rocket turrets. Got power. Access to our inventory cargo bay. Got O2 and a mini constructor just in case. Back here we got our O2 oxygen generator so that we can refill our oxygen while we are out and about. Pretty much the same on these sides here, but over here we got ourselves a fridge. Ah, that's gonna get annoying. I thought I'd do that, maybe hoping that these little things here have some armor on them, that they might protect those little spots there. It's kind of the same reason I put the landing gear along the bottom there to protect my RCS. But yeah, like I said, that is the ship. Let's go take it for a little spin. An official little spin. This thing does get off and going. Go ahead and load up my guns. Let's go ahead and let's break Admiral. Let's get out of let's finally leave Akua. Just get into space and have a look around. We won't actually attack anything. I'm gonna have to get some I'm gonna have to wait till I have enough Sathium to make some armored steel blocks. Then I can go ahead and start armoring this up, and then we can use this for some attack. Said freighter spotted carrying value. Yeah, here is our ship. It's very squat, seems the side are pretty neat. Hey, there's the planet. I believe that little spit right there is about where our base is. It's right around in that area, I'm thinking. Or maybe no. Sorry. Somewhere along in there, our base is. But yeah. What are you? Thermica Station? Okay, you're combat. You're firing at me. I'm leaving. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. I didn't say I was ready for combat. I did say I wasn't going to be doing combat until I got armor. Real armor. I don't remember that being there. That must be new with the new update. That or I've just never been lucky enough to have one spawn close. Whew. We'll have to take a look at that when we have a chance. I want to try and get over these asteroids. I want to see if we have any Sathium asteroids over here. And I may go ahead and make a change to some of these side thrusters. See if we can't get a little more power in the side thrusters. I'm not seeing any Sathium, though. Well, this is a test flight anyway. Oh, wait. I saw a little icon over here. It's usually a representation of Sathium. Oh, no, that's a Neodymium asteroid. Okay. As part of the exploratory mission to be out in space. Make sure I put my helmet on. Make sure my jetpack is on. Let's come over here and we'll mine some neodymium in space! Space! Oh, whoa. Twitch. There we go. Our first officially mined neodymium. I was actually having a pretty decent amount of neodymium that we found in those, one, the abandoned mine that they could see, and then that little base we found, I believe, had some neodymium in it as well. I think it has some Sathium as well, too. It had some Erustrum. That was awesome. But that's all. Okay, so let's go ahead and get back to base, and we'll call the episode. Like I said, this was mostly just to get this built and a quick test flight. Yeah, I thought that was the trade station, but the trade station is right over in this area? Yeah, this should be the trade station. Yeah, there it is. That's the trading station. That's what I thought that Thermica station was. Oh, this is a different design than I remember. Huh. Anyway. Let's go ahead and go back home. Our home is down in this direction. Not, because I just discovered something new. There's the back part of that. Okay, I am not where I thought I was. Should just go this way. There it is! It's like tall and narrow. I don't know. And yeah, that's one of the things about when you dig into a... dig into the station. See, that's what it's supposed to do. If I could fly better, it would work better. So yeah, just park it down. Alright, we can cut power and it'll drop us and it should level itself up. A little bit of a wobble, but there we go. We have successfully built, flown out, then back in. And turned around and been able to ready to launch again. I don't know what I want to call this thing yet, though. I haven't made a decision on a name. I have, though, and we're going to go ahead and do this now while I'm thinking about it. An ignominious name for our little mining hovercraft back here. Now you'll notice I have two of them. I went ahead and built one of the ladybug mining craft off of the forums, or off the workshop. It can mine that little patch of iron over there a lot better than this thing can, since I butchered that iron vein with this thing. So I'm just kind of using this to kind of grab the nodes that I've already got mined with by hand. But this thing has gotten better at mining as long as I'm doing it fresh. If I go at it fresh, I can get in there and I can get a good bit. I went out and got about 2 stacks of cobalt pretty quickly with this thing. But, like I said, I want to go ahead and save this. Let's see, I believe it's... right alt and O. Yes, okay. This is just going to be the sled. That's just what I've been calling it myself, so I'm just going to call it the sled. It may get worked on at some point. I may actually try and do some decorations and shit, but right now it is just the sled. Like I said, I don't know what I want to call this yet. I may just call it the flying fridge, because it looks like a refrigerator. It's just a box. I mean, it's not exactly a Borg cube, but it is very boxy. Like I said, once I get, some Sathium, I'll come back here, and all these, steel components I'll take out and replace with, battle steel, or... battle armor, whatever it's called there. But, I hope you've enjoyed. If you have, please like, subscribe, leave comments below. I try to follow them and answer as quickly as possible on most of them. Also, if you are enjoying and you want to give me a helping hand here while things are tight and that, I do have a Patreon page. No requirements on anything like that. But it does help out, every little bit does, with bills and such. And I'm going to have to get some more magnesium, it looks like. But until next time, take it easy, This has been the Grub, playing some Empyrion Galactic Survival. We have our hangar base, and pretty much this base is done. I can't really think of anything else I want to do with it. So, next episode, we're going to the moon. Or the moon, sorry. I say moon. I still say moon as if I'm playing Kerbal. I haven't played Kerbal in so long, though. Maybe I'll try and play that again. See how bad I suck at it since I haven't played in so long and there's been so many changes. Anyway, take it easy, folks. Goodbye.